Welcome to this YouTube channel. We are going to talk about top 5 most strongest acids in the world. So before starting this video, please like this video, and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. What makes an acid strong or weak? To answer this question, we first need to look at the definition of an acid. It is a chemical compound that accepts electrons and/or donates hydrogen ions, also known as protons. Therefore, the acidity levels of an acid depend on its ability to disassociate hydrogen ions, i.e., the higher the number of hydrogen ions produced by the acid in a solution, more acidic it is. So in order to scale the superacids based on their acidity levels, researchers came up with Hammett acidity function. It was initially suggested by American physical chemist Lewis Plaque Hammett. They are also able to neutralize any alkalis or chemicals that have a sour taste. But how to determine the strength of an acid? Number of ions released for every molecule can tell you about the strength of acids. We are surrounded by acid because even our stomach has hydrochloric acid, while vinegar and milk are also acids. Here we will tell you about the most strongest acids. Number 5, fluorosulfuric acid. HO value, -15.1 pKa value, -10, fluorosulfuric acid is a free-flowing colorless liquid. It is soluble in polar organic solvents, e.g. nitrobenzene, acetic acid, and ethyl acetate, but poorly soluble in nonpolar solvents such as alkanes. Reflecting its strong acidity, it dissolves almost all organic compounds, that are even weak proton acceptors. Fluorosulfonic acid appears as a fuming liquid. Boiling point 163 degrees Celsius. Density 1.73 grams per cc. Corrosive to metals and to tissue, both very short contact and the fumes can cause severe painful burns. Used as a catalyst in organic synthesis, in electroplating and as a fluorinating agent. Fluorosulfonic acid appears as a fuming liquid. Fluorosulfuric acid is the second strongest single component acid available today. It's yellow in appearance and of course highly corrosive, toxic. HSO3F is generally produced by reacting hydrogen fluoride with sulfur trioxide, and when combined with antimony pentafluoride, it produces magic acid, a far stronger acid and protonating agent. The acid can be used to alkylate hydrocarbons, with alkenes, and isomerize alkanes, and for glass etching, glass art. It's a common fluorinating agent in laboratories. Number 4, perchloric acid. pKa value, -10, -15.2, perchloric acid is among the strongest known Bronsted-Lowry acids, which have powerful oxidizing properties and is highly corrosive. Traditionally, it's produced by treating sodium perchlorate with hydrochloric acid, HCl, which also creates sodium chloride. Unlike other acids, perchloric acid is not vulnerable to hydrolysis. It is also one of the most regulated acids in the world. Back in 1947, in Los Angeles, California, about 150 people were injured, and 17 died due to a chemical explosion that contained nearly 75% perchloric acid, by volume, and 25% acetic anhydride. It also damaged more than 250 nearby buildings and vehicles. A cold 70% aqueous perchloric acid solution is considered to be a strong acid or superacid, stronger than sulfuric and nitric acids, but is not necessarily a strong oxidizing agent. However, as the concentration and temperature of the perchloric acid are increased, so does its oxidizing power. Number 3, fluorinated carborane acid. HO value, -18 pKa value, -20. Carborane acids are one of the strongest groups of superacids known to humans, few of which are considered to have a Hammett acidity function value, as low as -18, that's more than a million times stronger acidity level, than pure, 100%, sulfuric acid. One such member of this group is fluorinated carborane acid. While the existence of such a chemical was initially reported in 2007, researchers were able to study the full extent of its nature only in 2013. Before its discovery, the crown of strongest Bronsted acid went to a highly chlorinated version of this superacid family. Fluorinated carborane is the only known acid which can protonate, transfer of hydrogen ion, carbon dioxide to produce hydrogen-bridged cations. In contrast, CO2 doesn't go through any remarkable protonation when treated with other superacids like magic acid and HF antimony 5 fluoride. There are many proposed applications for the boron-based carborane acids. For instance, they have been proposed as catalysts for hydrocarbon cracking and isomerization of N-alkanes to form branched isoalkanes, isooctane, for example. Carborane acids may also be used as strong, selective Bronsted acids for fine chemical synthesis, where the low nucleophilicity of the counteranion may be advantageous. In mechanistic organic chemistry, they may be used in the study of reactive cationic intermediates. In inorganic synthesis, their unparalleled acidity may allow for the isolation of exotic species, like salts of protonated xenon. Number 2. Magic acid. HO value, -23. In addition to the obligatory gloves and goggles, the use of a face shield and full face respirator are also recommended. Predictably, magic acid is highly toxic upon ingestion and inhalation, causes severe skin and eye burns, and is toxic to aquatic life. Magic acid has low nucleophilicity, allowing for increased stability of carbocations in solution. The classical, trivalent carbocation can be observed in the acid medium, and has been found to be planar and sp2 hybridized. Because the carbon is surrounded by only 6 valence electrons, it is highly electron deficient and electrophilic. It is easily described by Lewis dot structures, because it contains only 2 electron, 2 carbon bonds. Many tertiary cycloalkyl cations can also be formed in superacidic solutions. One such example is the 1-methyl-1-cyclopentyl cation, which is formed from both the cyclopentane and cyclohexane precursor. In the case of the cyclohexane, the cyclopentyl cation is formed from isomerization of the secondary carbocation to the tertiary more stable carbocation. Cyclopropyl carbenium ions, alkenyl cations, and arenium cations have also been observed. While magic acid is generally used to stabilize carbonium ions in solutions, it has few other important industrial applications. For example, it can accelerate the isomerization of saturated hydrocarbons, and even protonate methane, xenon, and halogens, all of which are all weak bases. Number 1. Fluoroantimonic acid. Fluoroantimonic acid is perhaps the strongest of all known superacids based upon the Hammett acidity function values. It's produced by mixing hydrogen fluoride with antimony pentafluoride, generally in a 2-to-1 ratio. This reaction is exothermic in nature. It has been shown to protonate even hydrocarbons to afford pentacoordinate carbocations, carbonium ions. It is exceptionally corrosive and can only be stored in containers lined with Teflon. Fluoroantimonic acid thermally decomposes when heated, generating free hydrogen fluoride gas and liquid antimony pentafluoride. This superacid has several essential applications in the chemical engineering and petrochemical industry. For example, it can be used to separate methane and H2 from neopentane and isobutane, both alkane, respectively. Now, most of you might have stumbled upon carborane acids, either chlorinated carborane acid or fluorinated carborane acid, when searching for the strongest acids in the world. Well, technically, they are correct, since carborane acids are the strongest known single component acids on Earth, far more acidic than the likes of perchloric and trifluoric acid. Fluoroantimonic acid is actually a mixed acid. It is true that all these chemicals can be hazardous under some right conditions. Most of the chemicals suffer from a bad reputation. But we cannot forget the wide benefits of acids in the lives of people. Therefore, we have made a list of the strongest acids. We also hope that this article will help you in the best way of your knowledge about acids. What do you think of our list? Which of the acids shocked you the most? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.